I've been lucky enough to be at the Emmys the last few years. It's a great night, and hosting something like that is a great honor. With me, it's all about having really good jokes, so hired really good joke writers, and hopefully we'll have a fun monologue. That's sort of my strength. I can't sing or dance, so that's a sneak peek I will get you, is there will be no singing or dancing. I think the best hosts are the ones who sort of shape the show around their strengths, and I feel like that's what we're trying to do with this approach. So, you know, I think the biggest mistake you could make is trying to emulate someone who has a better skill set than you or a different skill set than you. So we're just going to try to do the best possible Emmys for Seth Meyers. I was really excited when the nominations came out because I'm a huge fan of television. I thought this was an exceptional year. I thought a lot of those great shows were represented on the night. So once the hard part of doing a monologue is over, it'll just be great to be backstage and see who actually gets to win on this night. As the host, I can't pick favorites, but I do have them. The nominees, the jokes, the commercials. They pay for these things. You gotta watch the commercials. The style and the fashion, I'm counting that as one. And the ending. It's always great when things end because then you can go around for the rest of your day. The television viewer is the big winner. Because no matter what happens at the Emmys, they have been the ones who've gotten all this wonderful TV to watch. Mostly just try to surround yourself with really talented people who can write really good jokes. I think you have to take these things fairly seriously and give yourselves the time to make sure that when the night actually rolls around, there's nothing left to do except for fine-tuning. So that's the biggest way to prepare, is just surround yourself with smart people.